Okay, so what we're doing today is we're getting the closet portion of the bathroom area done, and hopefully, with any luck, we'll get the front wall done tomorrow, maybe even some of it done tonight. But right now, I've got this piece of plywood cut, which covers this section of the staircase. I also have the plywood cut for this section of the staircase. And first I'm gonna install this piece, then I will go and get the other piece and bring it in and install it right here. We did laundry today, so Addie's got some socks hanging up along the inside of the hallway there. The board that goes here will make the other hallway wall and then the back wall of the closet. And this is obviously the side wall of the closet here. And then what'll happen is somewhere about right here where my shadow is falling on the ground is where the doorway is that goes into the bathroom. So it'll be a wall that goes right here and a wall that goes right here. This rafter right here is that you see is the line that will be made into the wall right there. So there'll be plenty of bathroom space down here. And it's actually it's already been being used as bathroom space, and this section here has already been is being used as closet space anyway, because we've been having these two bookshelves there that's been taking up that space. So we're already used to this space being used for its current purposes that we are building in. We're just actually doing the finish work on it now, making it look nice and getting it done. Although it's still got a lot of work to do to actually finish getting it to the point where it will look nice. Eventually it'll all be painted and look like a normal house, and it won't look so slapped together and junked up. But when I go to put the plywood here, I will have to remove this post here, and this piece right here actually won't be going back in. The actual wall stud corner piece of the wall will go right here. So the plywood will go up against the wall here, and I'll put in a new brace where the wall will begin to come out right here, and the plywood will be screwed into these. These are the handrails for the staircase, obviously. So, okay, set the camera here. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see very well, but I'm just gonna set the plywood up so you can see what it can look like when it's in position. Basically, that's the first piece of plywood right there, and we've been using this sheet here as a curtain wall for now, but hopefully in a few days we won't have to use that anymore. But there's the first piece. I just got to screw it on, and in a minute I'll have Addie come in and hold it in place while I screw it up, and then we'll get the next board up. Okay, talk to you in a few minutes. Okay, so I got the back panel, or the sidewall of the closet up, and I've got the back wall of the closet and sidewall of the hallway up, and got the railings back up too. So what I need to do now is to stabilize this end, and it also becomes part of this wall here. I have to build the corner joint, or corner joist, that goes right here, and will attach. It'll nail to the floor, and it'll nail to this ceiling joist section here. And then once I install that, which will nail on here and run down along this edge here, then I'll have something to nail this or screw on this end of the plywood to. And I also need to run a board back across here too, so I have something to nail or screw the top of the plywood to. But this whole corner down here is done, and then I have a 2x4 that I need to cut to put in to fill that gap in there, to frame that part in. But here's where we're at right now. So now I'm going to start measuring and everything, and I'm going to make my corner piece. I'm going to measure out where my doorway is going to go, and I'm going to put in my a bottom plate for the frame and the top plate for the frame and build in my corner joist there, and then that'll probably be what I get done today. I'm going to hopefully maybe get this whole corner wall section right here done, if I'm lucky. And then tomorrow, I could probably get this whole section done. So luckily, it hasn't been raining all day, and I've been able to run the generator and have the power cord come in and get the power saw to cut. But the plywood I have to cut with the power saw outside, because it just with the power saw, it just throws up sawdust and everything everywhere. But the 2x4s, even if it's raining, I could bring the 2x4s inside and cut them with a handsaw. So I wanted to get this stuff done today while it was nice and sunny out. So now the plywood's done and cut, doesn't matter what the weather's like tomorrow. So that's good. I can use hand tools for the rest of it. And I can use the screw gun, it gets done inside and that doesn't make a mess. So, alrighty, back to work. Okay, so I got the first frame section of the wall up here, and basically, it's on, it's all screwed up, starting to look together and come together. I still have a board that I need to put down in that corner, and one I need to put across the roof there. But other than that, I also have the 2x4 that has to go down into that. But I mean, it's starting to come together. It's actually quite dark outside now. It's nighttime, so I'm running the propane lantern so that y'all can see on the camera, because even though I can see clear as day just fine with my LED lighting in here, the frequency of the LED lighting doesn't work with the GoPro camera very well, so I have to use the propane light so that you can see what I'm talking about. But I'm going to do a little bit more work tonight and finish off this back wall across there. I'll do the 2x4 section later. I don't have any 2x4 to do that, so that little corner piece is going to have to be done later, because what I'm working with here is 2x3 to build this front wall with. And that corner there has to be 2x4 because that's what the original construction is made out of. And so that's what the gap is. So I'll probably use this 2x4 here. Actually, was the railing that went right here, and I haven't decided if I'm going to put, because it went right here where the wall is, but since the wall's there now, we have this extra piece of 2x4 here, which I can either put there in that gap where the Nesquik is, or I could put back right here on the end here. I gotta talk to my wife and find out what she wants and see how she wants these handrails to come in, and we might just cut these handrails off is what I want to do. If she agrees with taking the saw and cutting off the ends of these handrails, which would actually open up a lot more space because it'd make it easier to get to the staircase, then that means I could take this 2x4 here and use it to fill that gap over there. And gotta make sure I pull those nails out before I go to bed. So, yes, the cabin is a mess. When you're under construction, you don't really have anywhere to put stuff, so things get piled up, and things are gonna stay piled up until, well, one, we're building a closet here so that we can store things properly. But anyhow, it's getting done. Tomorrow I will have this entire wall done, provided everything cooperates, and but for you guys, you'll get to see it all in one video. So, okay, since Addie's here, real quick, what's your opinion on these? I want to cut these off flush with the wall because it'd make it easier for us to get and make that corner go in. And I know you and Ralph are going to be bumping into those all the time.
What if we rounded them a little? Because I'm also really clumsy, and having something I can grab at the last second.
Yeah. Well, I could do that too, because what we could do, what I was telling them on the camera, is I could put this on here, back on here. It used to be right here where the end wall is. But then I could put it here.
Right.
And then, but we still have those nubs there. But I need a piece of 2x4 like this to fill that gap over there.
No, that's fine. I don't think we need that. I think this is going to be okay here. Just maybe round these to little lumps that I could just, if I had to, grab on.
So we can take my jigsaw and we'll round those off like we did the table there.
And I might...
But I don't think they need to stick out that far. Maybe half of that.
Can we take one of those pieces or something and put something so I'm...
Do we need this bottom one on there?
Maybe not, no.
Okay, so we'll saw that bottom one completely off and round this one off for you to have a nub there to grab.
Right. This, okay. I'm so going to kick a lot.
There's nothing I could do about that.
Stay. I was wondering if we could...
No, I can't do anything with that.
Around it maybe eventually.
That has to stay. I could put a kickboard on there, but I can't do anything with it.
We can get this stuff you get for your Hearthstone. Those little bumper things so you don't like... Or for your babies on counters.
Yeah.
So when I do kick it, I'm not kicking it. Okay. Back.
Alrighty, so there you have it. Talk to you later. Okay, so I got a late start this today to get working on the bathroom walls because we had to run into town and I had to pick up two boxes of coarse thread screws long enough to go through the 2x4s, or I should say 2x3s, and whatnot. So I got two boxes of those this morning, and then I had to meet up with somebody I was going to be bartering with, and I might talk about that in another video. But for now, about 2 o'clock I got to get started and took up a bunch of measurements and talked about how we were going to do the wall and everything. So we ended up coming up with this. So this is the divider wall that I got installed today so far, and I've got a bunch more work I'm going to be doing this afternoon. So what we have here is the divider wall between the storage closet underneath the staircase and the composting toilet. And when I sit down here, as you see, there's plenty of room for the toilet area. There's the shower wall here and then the closet wall there. That's great. And there will be a plywood backing on here. My hand was the plywood, that's where it'd be, obviously. The plywood's gonna go on the inside of the closet side. This side will not be paneled at all because we're gonna use each one of these rungs as a shelf, which is why there's so many. And we're gonna put one or two strands of a bungee cord on here from this one over to this side, going across here. So anything that we put on the shelf will be held in place by the bungee cord, so it shouldn't fall off because the shelves are so narrow. So we're going to put like our shampoo bottles, soap bottles, bars of soap, our toilet paper rolls, all that kind of good stuff. We'll put a toilet paper roll dispenser on one of them, probably like this rung here or maybe this rung here, whichever one Addy wants. And we'll paint it up all nice and neat and sand it and get some wood putty filler to fill in any cracks or anything, make it all look nice and neat. But before we do all of that, obviously we still gotta drywall this back, finish drywalling the back wall. And then this water tank here, we'll put in a plug on here, and we're gonna have it upright just like you see it here, only this side right here will be up against the wall. And it's gonna be mounted on the wall right here. There is a hose. I don't know if you can see it right here. This hose right here will be the inlet hose for the water from the 300 gallon tank outside. We'll fill in from there, and at the bottom on the same side as that hose we'll put another hose in, which will be the output, which will run to the water pump, which will remount underneath the tank right here. And that water pump will pump the water to the shower and eventually to the sink that's going to be over there. So for that's the cold water, and then we'll have a separate hot water system eventually. So alrighty, so this right here fits perfectly right here. And then we have decided that our medicine cabinet, which is right there, needs to be sanded and painted and whatnot, cleaned up. But the wall that's gonna go along right here, eventually it's going to hang on the inside of the wall directly where the toilet is. So right where I'm standing. You know, if you were sitting on the toilet, you'd see it. But now I got to move all of this stuff here. Move it over here to move it all over to here. Everything's cluttered because we're doing construction work and stuff. He's got a big stack of wood there on some crates, and this paper here, it looks like trash. That's where we store two buckets here of paper that we use for fire starter. And then the rest is Addie's work clothes and some stuff that we had in storage over there. So we got to move all this stuff over and clear it all out. I got to move my gun box and all that stuff. Still not sure exactly where the gun box is going to go. Might end up upstairs. But what I'm going to do now, once all this stuff is moved, I have a frame, box frame, that's going to go from the ceiling all the way down to the floor. And it'll be 3 or maybe 4 different levels. And as what is going to happen is, it's going to be where we stack our firewood. So the wall itself will actually just be a frame, a box frame, and then the firewood will actually be what fills the wall for just a 2-foot section all the way up from the roof all the way to the floor. And you'll see what I mean once it's done. And then from about here on will be an actual regular normal wall. And then right here's the door. So that'll be kind of cool. So, and as long as it's filled with firewood, you won't be able to see into the bathroom or anything. The reason for that is we have to have a place inside the cabin where we can stack as much firewood as possible for the wintertime. So if we build the wall so that the firewood can be stacked inside the wall, then A, we get a wall, and B, we get the firewood, and C, we don't take up any extra space than what is absolutely necessary. So, and then, alrighty. So that's what we're working on right now. And then I'm gonna cut the video off here, get back to work, get this turned off so it stops heating up the place. See the difference there? I do have both LED lights on, and it is pretty much bright as daylight in here, but due to the frequency of the LEDs, it doesn't really match the frequency of the camera, so you can't see much. So alrighty, we'll talk to you later. Okay, so I have gotten the section of the wall that will be storing our firewood for the winter done. So we have 3 sections here, and basically our largest logs we'll set down on the bottom. Let me grab one here. For example, we'll just use this log for example. It'll set down there like that. Hopefully it's not too dark. But we stack our logs across there. And then we have our medium logs here. Stack all the way across. And then we have our bigger logs. I mean our smaller logs. They'll stack across here. And of course we'll fill it all the way up to the top. And that is our firewood stand. And this is where our firewood was always stacked before. It was just stacked on milk crates all last winter. So right now we're not using the fireplace right now. Summertime, we have not even lit it up in months. So we currently just took the wood and stuck it back there, but that is not where we store our wood. This is where we will be storing our wood this winter on the shelf. This back right here is the back of my gun case. And for now, this is where my gun case is going to be stored, on the back side of this, until we find a better place to put it. Yeah, I mean, it's basically had its back up against that wall like you saw earlier in the videos. And it's been there this whole time. We haven't had any humidity issues or anything inside the case. So I'm hoping that it remains that way. But it probably will be, now that I have the walls built and everything else, it'll probably have a better chance of getting humidity inside of it. So I'm probably going to need to get those dehumidifier containers that you put in there. If I notice that there is a humidity problem with my gun case there, then I guess I'll have to take it upstairs or find another place for it. Not a whole lot of room to do things, so. But anyways, all that's left now, it's really coming together. All that's left now is to build the next piece of the wall that comes out to right here, where my toe is. Right there to there is the next wall piece that comes in. And once this wall is in, then I eventually this side right here, this piece right here actually juts into the bathroom side. So eventually I will have to put a piece of plywood in right here because I want to close that off. Because what I want to do once this wall is up right here is take triangle pieces of plywood and make little triangle shelves about 1 foot spaced, or maybe 10 inches or 8 inches spaced apart all the way down, because we want to make as much shelving as we can in every possible place. We'll be doing the same thing right here as well, triangle shelving all the way up, so wherever possible. We'll be putting a shelf right across here too. Don't know what we'll be using all the shelves for, but there's always good for shelving space. We'll be putting a board across up here too, 1x12, and that'll be pocket shelves as well. Then of course I'll be putting a board on this, and that'll be shelf space, and we'll probably do that all the way across here. Okay, it's coming along. One more section of the wall, and the wall is done. Saw a battery down there, don't know where it came from. Anyways, alrighty. One more section of the wall, and then the framing part's done. This section of the wall from this part to where my toe is, it's just going to be basically a foot plate to here and a top plate, a base plate and a top plate, and then a corner beam that comes up right down here. And then inside the wall, we're going to use probably 1x4 slats, very similar to these 1x6s right here, and except these are probably going to be a little too wide, so we want to get a bunch of 1x4s. And they're going to sit at an angle, like louvers, I guess they're called. So they'll be louvered all the way down and slightly overlap each other, but there'll be gaps. So that's the reason for that is the hot air from the stove rises. It comes out and it rises. And so what that will allow is when the heat radiates off the stove, it'll come in and it'll reach under the louvers and it'll rise up and heat into the bathroom area. And also, you know, the heat will also be able to come in, pass through the cracks in the wood pile here, and also be able to heat up the bathroom too. The only part that won't have any airflow through it is this one little section of wall right here, because eventually there will be a piece of plywood on this back side right here. And I'm putting little shelves in here, just like I said I was going to do with this one here. As you can see, I put 1, 2, 3 shelves in there. Although I have decided my medicine cabinet there, we are considering taking the medicine cabinet, chopping this shelf out wherever, I forgot the measurement, but we're gonna pull these two screws out and saw this wherever the width of the medicine cabinet is, saw it out here, put in a stud right there, and then slip the medicine cabinet right into the side of this wall here. And then that way we have the medicine cabinet here, the water tank there, the water pumps and everything directly underneath the tank, and then of course the hoses will come over to there. All of our plumbing and electrical is all surface mounted so that we have complete access to it. Eventually this is all going to be painted and whatnot, so it's all going to look nice. So, it's coming along, and basically the amount of hours I put in yesterday and the amount of hours I put in today, it's one full day's worth of work. If I had started 8 o'clock in the morning and worked till 8 o'clock in the evening, you know, that'd be one full day's worth of work that I put into it, taking my time, relaxing, going slow, doing it by myself, and designing it as I go. I didn't really have a design in mind exactly. I just had a general idea, no blueprints or anything that I'm going by. My wife just and I talked about it a few times, and we've been changing ideas as we go too. So, but this is what we got. To show you here, this is all reinforced. So these boards here are screwed into the side studs. As you see here, there's two screws in on each end of these resting boards. And then there's the support boards that also have two screws on each side as well. So we can put a lot of weight on there. I could get on that and jump up and down. Same thing with this floor here. And then obviously this is supported by the floor itself. And then these top ones, you know, rest on there. So it's very strong, very supported. Should be able to handle a crap ton of weight. A whole lot more weight than we're ever going to throw on it for the firewood. So, okay, let me get the rest of this done. It's 9:15. It's pouring down rain and it's pitch black outside. So the rest of the work tonight is hand saws. I got lucky. Or I should say the cat got lucky. And voila, the cat box still fits in its same place. Wasn't sure if that was going to happen or not. But luckily the cat box still fits in there. And my medicine cabinet will go there and the water tank will go there. So everything's going to fit perfectly. And then if the water tank ever springs a leak, there'll be the cat box there to catch it all. Yay! Of course the cat won't like it very much. But okay, moving on along. The cabin's finally coming together. Slowly. Okay, so I have finished pretty much everything I can do for my walls. I need two sheets of 1/4-inch plywood, because I need to cut one piece to go on the back side of this here, finish off this portion, and I need one sheet to go on this side here to finish off this wall, and then that wall will be done. And then I need obviously paint to paint it all. And I need the 1x4s to make the vertical slats that go down this section here to fill this gap here. We're making 45 degree angles or whatever angle it comes out to be. We're going to take 1x4s. I don't have any here to show you, but pretend my hand is a 1x4. They'll go in at angled slats like this. About, I don't know, maybe a 1/2 inch or 3/4 inch apart all the way down to create kind of like a louver, like a closet door would have, from the top all the way down to this rung here. And that would allow the heat, like I was talking about earlier, from the wood stove to come over and then go up in to the bathroom, but without you being able to see into the bathroom or see out of the bathroom. And but I still got to purchase those. I got to figure out how many I need. This internal space here is 27 inches from here to here. And then I'm going to have to count out how many I'm going to need. So I got some mathematics left to do there. But other than that, it's pretty much done. The LED light bar used to be attached right across here. But of course, I had to take it down so I could put the new wall up. Now it's just laying right here. I will put it back up in a more semi-permanent position. I'm trying to get it back up on there one-handed. There you go. I will put it back up. It will eventually go right up on this one right here, or maybe on this one here. Once the bathroom is completed and all the wiring in the cabin is permanent, then the official light will go right here. So one light strip will go here and one light strip will go right here. So we'll have two light strips in the bathroom, and pretty much the same light strip you see right there. And then that way we might even find an LED light to put into the actual shower stall itself. So on a separate switch. But we'll see. I did find some really cool plug-and-play LED connectors that allows you to plug six of these LED strips into one plug, and then you plug that plug in to a wire like this. This goes to my, this is a 10 gauge wire that ran to my water pump down there, which also was in the way of this wall here, which I had to cut down. And don't worry, I disconnected the power to it before pulling it down, but I have to reconnect it so that we can get showers tonight. And looks like my propane tank is running out of fuel, so I'm gonna cut this short. But pretty much I'm done today. Sometime, let's see, probably on the 1st, I'll go and pick up, when I get paid, I'll go and pick up the 1x4s for this, and be able to put that in. Not exactly sure how I'm gonna do it, or if it's even possible for me to do it the way I want to, but we'll see. So, okay. Then for those that don't really understand what this is for, let me just cut some wood here. This is for stacking wood. That piece is too small. As you see there, all this entire area from the floor up to here will be stacked up with the big heavy chunks for like what we call overnighter wood. The wood from here all the way up to the ceiling here will be stacked with wood like this for cooking and day use wood. So when we have the wood, the fireplace going during the day in the winter time, this is where we will keep our wood stockpiled. That way it's in the house that we could probably stock. Each one of these sections will probably, probably do 2 days worth of wood that we could store in here. Maybe 3 days in the fall worth of wood. Each section could probably hold a day's worth of wood per section for the fall and early spring. In the winter time, if it's anything like last winter, probably hold this whole section here, probably hold 2 days worth of wood. So that's the goal there. And as long as we stock it every day, then it will stay full, and you won't be able to see into the bathroom. And even in the summertime, even though we're not using the wood stove in the summertime, we just come in, we keep it stocked all summer long full of wood now that it's built. So the next step is that we're gonna go, if it ever stops freaking raining outside, it's been nonstop pouring down thunderstorms for about a little over a week now. So, but if it ever stops pouring down rain, we'll go split some wood. We've got a lot of wood out there, about 3 or 4 months worth of wood stockpiled so far. We'll go split some and we'll fill this hole up, and we'll show you what that's like once it's full. So, alrighty, now I gotta clean everything up and put everything away and get our bookshelves back over here when Addie gets home from work, and because I need some help moving those over. But we are done for now with what I can do. Still have some, actually got some of this wood left, which we'll probably use for, we'll definitely use it for some other projects. I think Addie's working on a chicken coop design, which if we ever get around to being able to afford some plywood, then we'll use it for that. If not, I got some shelves and some other stuff that we're gonna use. So about 7 or 8 pieces left, I think. And a bunch of scraps, so that's good. Okay, anyways, thanks for watching. All right, so I am hoping you can see the wall. It's not that dark in here, but there it is. The divider wall is up. And it's got 2 shelves up here that can be used for, most likely Addie will put her ponies up here. She's got her My Little Pony Brigade sitting there, and I think she's intending to use these 2 shelves for that. So, but anyway, this is the louver wall, or breathable wall, or whatever you want to call it. As you can see, it for the most part, blocks your view into the bathroom, but will still allow the heat from the stove to rise up through the louvers that way. So if you like get on the ground and you look upwards, you can kind of see in, but that's basically it. Now if you come around into the bathroom and you're standing in the bathroom, you can actually see out. But the cool thing is in here you can see out, but out there you can't see in. That's kind of cool. And it'll allow all the heat from the stove to come in through the wall, and it'll allow humidity from the shower in there to come out and go into the cabin. Because when you're running a wood stove in a cabin with burning wood heat, then you usually have to have some kind of humidifier or a pot of water or something on a wood stove all the time, because wood heat sucks out all the moisture in the air. So we kind of kill two birds with one stone by having a breathable wall. It allows the humidity from the bathroom into the living room and the rest of the house, and it allows the heat from the stove into the bathroom to keep the bathroom area warm. So, all right, that's basically all I'm gonna be doing with this video episode. All that's left now is to put in there will be drywall that goes on here and slides in behind this piece and butts up against here. So this will have, I don't know if you can see that, my hand back there. There will be drywall up in there, and you know, all the way down. So the insulation will be covered, and then there will also be a piece of plywood on top of here, so this will actually be a nice thick air gap there. And same thing with each level going down, so the insulation won't be exposed all the time. Then it has to be painted. Come around here, there needs to be piece of plywood put on right here. So what I need to do is take a, not exactly sure how I'm going to do it, but probably take another 2x3 and screw it on right here up to the top and screw it all the way down, you know, to the bottom, so that I can make something to attach the plywood on right here. And what's going to happen there is shelves, little mini shelves, are going to be put in all the way down here. So this will be blocked off with plywood, and then little mini shelves put in. I may even put the plywood on the inside here, where my hand is, on the inside where the firewood goes, and then take 2x3s and then put in the little mini shelves right in there, just like that. And then you know, every little bit of shelving space will help. So, okay, we will get some 1x12s, and there'll be a 1x12 that goes from across the rafters here, give us a 12-inch shelf there, and then we'll come out 12 inches and then put another 1x12, and then come out 12 inches and put another 1x12, and do that all the way across. And that's going to happen all the way across here. This is a 1x12, and as you can see, we use it for shelving. So as soon as we can afford a bunch of 1x12s, all of our rafter space will be turned into shelves all the way across the cabin. Even in the bathroom, we will have shelves everywhere, and wherever we have space for it. So right here, I need a piece of plywood to go there, and on this side, I need a piece of plywood to go there. Then these walls will be done. So I need two sheets of plywood, and this OSB board is $10.25 a board, so I could probably pick that up maybe next week, or possibly Monday. I don't know. I'll be in the next county over where the hardware store is on Monday, and we'll see what the finances are, but I think I can do that on Monday. If we do, we'll pick them up. That'll be $20, so Might have to wait till the week after next, actually. So, but anyways, once I get those two done, then that'll all be done. And we'll just be waiting on drywall. So, okay. Hope you enjoyed the series, building the video of building the bathroom. And have Addie pick out, we got a shower curtain rod. Grab that right here. We're using nice boards. Hold on, someone's at the door. Knock it off, it's just mom. The chickens and Addie just got home, so. But anyways, knock it off. This is the stick that we're using. As you can see, we use the natural wood from out on the property. We'll trim down the bark off of it and sand it down real nice. Or Addie might actually want to leave the bark on this one. But eventually, either way, it'll be cleaned up nice and stained. Cut down to the right size to be hung up right here. And then it'll become our curtain rod. And then we will have a curtain for a door. And we'll get eventually the curtain will be a split curtain. And what I mean by a split curtain is it'll be two curtain halves with magnets down the center. So when you walk through it, after you walk through it, the magnets will automatically close it. And it'll be attached, the curtains will be attached all the way down this side. And it'll be attached all the way down this side with snaps or something. Or Velcro, probably. Most likely Velcro down to this side. And then the center will be magnets. So you can just push your way in. And then they will automatically close. So that's the idea. But for now, until we get around to doing that, it'll just be a regular shower curtain or something. So, okay. Anyways, now we've got to go and put the bookshelves in and clean up all the mess. Thanks for watching.